Hello, everybody. Welcome to A Place of Grace, our Daily Lives edition. Today, I've got the king of healing headaches. I've got Dr. Chevelle. He is a world-renowned master of healing headaches. Dr. Chevelle, thank you for coming.
Thank you for inviting me.
You know, for you to be here, for me, it's such a big deal because I know how busy you are and how you're such a big person in the medical fraternity. Thank you for coming.
It's my greatest pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you. You know, it's so funny because I got to know about you a couple of years ago when I struggled with migraines. I didn't even know it was migraines. Mm-hmm. I always just said, I've got a headache. But there was a sequence on how it happened. I just didn't understand if there's a difference between headaches and migraines. Is there even a difference between those two things?
Well, they're basically the same disease, but when it becomes worse, when the pain becomes worse, and when you start having nausea and vomiting and light sensitivity, and then doctors will call it migraine. But there's no real difference in the underlying problem.
Okay, because what I didn't understand is that before the actual headache, let me call it that, my eyesight would become blurry. I feel like I've got a headache on one part of the head, and then I'd, at a later stage, vomit. And only after vomiting, I'd feel much better. What is happening in the body that causes all those things, from the blurriness to the vomiting to the throbbing? What causes that?
Blurriness, we don't understand the mechanism, but it's something that does happen with headaches and migraines. The vomiting, depending on how severe the pain is, severe pain can cause one to vomit.
Oh, okay.
So that's probably the cause of the vomiting. The pain moving from one spot to another, that happens with headache sufferers all the time. It starts one place, it moves to another place, and it moves to another. And there are reasons for this, and we can go into those just now. But that's a typical, very typical of the headaches and migraines.
But what is happening in one's head when one is experiencing a headache?
Okay, the very first thing that you have to understand is that nothing is happening inside one's head.
Okay.
It's all happening on the outside of the head. It is not a brain disease. It's something that happens on the outside, which does affect the brain. It makes the brain a bit more sensitive.
Oh.
But the problem is not inside the head. So the listeners mustn't be concerned that they're going to have some brain problem like a stroke or whatever, because it's not from the inside of the head.
Because that has always been my fear, because I used to think that if I go untreated, maybe I'll develop some other brain disease.
No, that's not. It's not a brain problem.
But what could happen? What was the worst thing that could happen from untreated migraines?
The worst thing that can happen is that they get worse and worse, and you suffer more and more pain. The reason for that is when you have a migraine, one obviously takes painkillers. But if you have to take painkillers on a regular basis, they may help for that headache. But slowly, the body gets used to them, and the headaches get worse and worse. So you take more and more medication, the headaches get worse and worse. And it's a vicious cycle. And at the headache clinic, we see people sometimes you're taking 20 headache pills a day.
Yes.
That's called medication overuse headache. So when we treat people and we get rid of the headache permanently, they can throw all the poison away.
We call it poison.
Absolutely.
But then if I'm experiencing headaches or migraines while I'm at home, before I get help, maybe from professionals or like yourself, what would you recommend I do to treat it while I'm still waiting to get help?
Well, you know, there's very little one can do. There are a few things. For instance, some people, what triggers a migraine is dehydration. So if that happens in your case, then you must keep yourself hydrated. You must drink enough water. Some people, it is triggered if they don't eat. So then they need to eat small meals a day. Some people have a food trigger like chocolate or alcohol or cheese. If they can identify the trigger, then they must not have it.
You know, now I'm remembering, as part of the things that would happen in my body, after vomiting, then the migraine would disappear. But I'd find that I'm extremely tired. What is happening in the body that causes fatigue?
You know, the body needs time to recover from such a painful episode.
Mm.
And in some people, it manifests as just fatigue, and so you lie down or you sleep for a while and then you're better.
Mm.
But it's a terrible insult to the body. It's difficult for the body to cope.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then in terms of lifestyle changes, because I honestly don't know what caused migraines from all of a sudden, because all my life I've been fine. It just started happening as an adult. Are there certain lifestyle changes in terms of maybe diets, meditation, things that we can do that could help prevent getting headaches and migraines?
Well, in some people, for instance, you mentioned diet. And as I said, if there are certain foods that you can definitely identify, every time you have it, you get a migraine, well, then you must just leave that until you can get help from the headache clinic.
Mm.
Then you can, after that, once we've treated you, you can eat or drink what you like and you won't get a headache. As far as exercise goes, this is an individual thing.
Mm.
Some people, when they exercise, they have fewer migraines. And in some people, exercise brings on a migraine. So that one has to try yourself.
Okay.
As far as meditation is a good thing.
Mm.
And it may well help if one wants to try it. There's no harm done.
Okay.
So certainly, yeah.
Okay. And then I struggle to understand. It's so funny. I would assume that when we are sleeping, we're much more relaxed. But I would find that sometimes we wake up with a headache. What causes us during sleep? What causes headaches when we wake up?
We're not always so relaxed when we sleep.
Okay.
You know, and particularly headache sufferers, they don't have some of them don't have a good sleeping pattern.
Mm.
And so you're not relaxed during sleep, and you might be tense during your sleep. And if you're tense, your muscles tense up, and that's where the pain really comes from.
Oh.
So you wake up with a headache in the morning, and sometimes you wake up in the middle of the night with a headache.
Are they tensing because I'm stressed, or it's the posture of my body?
What probably more stress.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. And then I've experienced that there are different types of headaches, because sometimes I feel it on the front, at the back. What causes the different parts, the different headaches, the one in the front, the one at the back, and how do each of them get treated differently?
Right. The different areas in front. Where, for instance, if you have a pain on your forehead, the origin of the pain is not on the forehead. It's at the back of the neck, near the middle of the neck. If you have a pain on the inside of the eye, it's another spot at the back. All the pain in front comes from somewhere where the muscles of the neck attach to the bone.
Okay.
It all comes from there. If you have eye pain, in the ball of the eye, it comes from a certain spot near the side here. If you have eye pain on the eyebrow, it comes from a different place.
Okay.
So what we do is we identify, when we see a patient, we identify by what we call palpating, by
applying pressure.
Finding where the tender parts are. And if a patient has a headache at the time, what I will do is I'll say, well, where exactly is your pain?
Mm.
And then if they say the pain is here, I know that there's a certain spot at the back, and I will press on that, and they'll say, yes, that's painful.
Mm.
If we give a little injection of local anesthetic to numb that spot, that pain goes away in minutes.
Okay.
Then it confirms to us exactly where the pain comes from. And that's the important part in headaches. We have to find out where does the pain come from. Once we know where it comes from, then it's not difficult to treat.
Let's make an example with a person who's experiencing the pain, maybe right here by the eyeball, and you are doing the pressure test to find out where the pain is coming from.
Yeah.
What is causing that pain? Is it stress? Is it posture issues? What is triggering those kind of pains?
People with headaches have all got a muscle tension problem. their muscles are more tense than normal.
Mm.
It's something that people tend to be born with. And when their muscles are tense, where the muscle joins onto the bone at the base of the skull is what's called a tendon. That tendon can stretch. And when it stretches, it becomes painful. And when the tendon at the back becomes painful, it causes pain in the front, depending on which tendon is causing the pain.
Mm.
So we identify that tendon.
And then when the headache is around the head, what is the do? What's different from the one in the front?
Well, it just means that it's a different spot, different places at the back.
Everything is checked at the back.
95% or more of headaches come from these places at the back.
So, because I'm still thinking, is it all surrounded? Because I know there's tension headache. I don't know what we call the other ones because I was diagnosed with a tension headache when you told me at that time. I don't know if all of us, we are just struggling with not relaxing our bodies, or there's just so much happening in our lives that is leading to that.
You know, it's difficult to say. For instance, I've never had a headache in my life. Even when I'm very...
What?
I'm lucky.
You guys, such a good lifestyle.
Even when I'm very tense.
Wow.
Because I obviously don't have that underlying muscle tension problem that some people are born with.
And then when the headache becomes numb to medication and I can't afford your services, what can I do to help myself to relieve the pain? Can I undo this taking of medication and find a way of healing my headache?
You know, only if you are aware of what triggers your headache.
Mm.
As I said, certain foods, try not to become stressed, but that's impossible in today's world. Mm. If exercise helps, you do exercise, meditation, as you said.
Mm.
But there's very little one can do, unfortunately.
Okay. And then, you know, I always used to fear falling pregnant while I still struggled with headaches. Does a person who's experiencing migraines expose the unborn baby to any form of dangers while they're going through that episode?
No, the migraine itself will not expose the baby to any form of danger. There's no literature that shows that at all, and they've done so many studies. The only thing that does expose the baby to problems is the medications that one takes.
Okay.
So all you can take during your pregnancy is Panado, which is not very strong, and it doesn't help much. So if people are thinking of having a baby or falling pregnant, they should come to the headache clinic first and let us get rid of the headache.
Okay.
And then they can go through their pregnancy with no problems.
Do kids even experience headaches?
Kids are built the same as we are.
Okay.
Now, the interesting thing is that children, boys and girls, have the same number of headaches. As soon as girls reach puberty and they start having their menstrual cycle, it goes to 3 to 1. A lot more girls, because the hormones are a trigger. The normal hormones in the hormone cycle.
Mm.
As just before menstruation, the estrogen levels drop off and the brain becomes more sensitive to pain impulses coming in from here. So people feel the pain more.
And then, okay, I'd understand us having tensions and stuff like that. What can a baby have tension for them to end up having?
Children have tensions.
Oh.
They're also upset sometimes.
How weird.
You know, people don't expect it, but yes, children certainly have headaches.
And then how do we pick up when a baby is... do we just classify everything as fever, or we can pick up when this is a headache issue?
Oh, in a baby that can't speak, you can't tell.
Can't tell. And then how does medication that we take, things like contraceptives, do they even contribute to us getting headaches?
You know, in some people, I find when they take a contraceptive, their headaches improve. And others, their headaches get worse. So that's also an individual thing.
Mm. In your years of practice, what have been some of the extreme cases that you've had to deal with?
Well, you know, we see this all the time. People who are having headaches every single day and migraines every single day and cluster headaches every single day, and their lives are ruined. Their family lives are ruined. Their True. Working lives are ruined. Mm. They can't function. And it's the most wonderful thing to be a doctor and to treat somebody like that and change their lives and bring them back to normality again.
Mm.
It's a wonderful feeling.
Yeah, because I can imagine having a headache every day of your life. You basically, you can't work.
You can't do anything.
True,
no.
You can't. From family life to work, nothing seems to work.
Mm.
And can a person die from headaches?
No. No, you know, people worry that they're going to get a stroke or they're going to get some brain problem.
Mm.
No, the headaches are, what they do is they ruin your life, but they're not going to kill anybody.
Yeah, it means I was chasing the air because I always used to fear that I'm going to be paralyzed or no. I'm just going to die from this headache.
No, because yeah. It's not a brain problem.
Mm. Yeah, and that's the misconception that we have, that something is happening inside of our brains. And then when I came to your practice, I found that I don't only see yourself. I see a couple of specialists.
Mm.
Can you please take us through as to how the procedure goes when a person visits your practice to be treated for a headache or migraine?
Sure. The first thing to do is one has to have a neurological examination because although the vast majority of headaches and head pain don't come from the brain, it is possible that there's a brain tumor or meningitis or something that's life-threatening. So the first examination is the neurological examination that makes sure that there's nothing wrong in the brain. Once we know that, then the patient goes to, we take a very detailed history that will suggest what x-rays need to be taken.
Mm-hmm.
We also do muscle tension tests on the jaw and neck muscles, which is very important because muscle tension causes most headaches and migraines. And we find that just about every single patient that we see with headaches has a muscle tension problem.
Okay,
and then once we've got all those tests, they come and see me.
Mm.
I collate all the information and I examine the patient for the tender spots in the neck to find out exactly where the pain's coming from.
I hear, because we've been talking about tension, headache. What other ones are there so that other people can see if...
Well, if the doctors have called it migraine, it's just a tension headache that's got worse. It's not a different disease.
Okay.
It's the same disease.
Okay.
It's just a different pattern in different people. Even a thing called cluster headache, which is terrible.
Mm.
It's far worse than others. It comes from the same thing.
What is a cluster headache?
It's a headache that they call it suicide headache because people commit suicide, it's so bad.
Wow.
The pain is so bad that when people get it, they walk around, they bang their head on the wall, they cry, they scream, and then it goes over in half an hour or so, and then in between, nothing. And then they can get it up to 8 times a day. I had a Japanese patient who came to see me who had cluster headache for 18 years, every single day. His wife divorced him, his life was in ruins, and when we treated him and he went back to Japan, with cluster headache, if you have one sip of alcohol, you get an attack. He went back to Japan. He drinks a bottle of wine a day. He's happy,
just
happy,
to
happy.
Just compensate for the other
and
years.
Even, we didn't know that he was very wealthy. He sent my wife and I tickets to go to Japan.
Oh, wow.
And took us around Japan for 10 days in a chauffeur-driven limousine.
Oh, wow.
That was fantastic.
The benefits.
Yeah, but his life changed.
Mm. Yeah, because you end up giving up. I mean, you can imagine with this person who's been having headaches for 18 years, cluster headaches for 18 years. Like, that pain makes you feel like you're going to get paralyzed. The way it is so severe, you just feel like you're going to get paralyzed. I remember one of the specialists I saw was a physiotherapist thing.
Mm-hmm.
Why do you include those people, the different people, before we actually get to your office?
Well, the physiotherapist, because this is mainly a muscular thing, sometimes physiotherapy helps as well.
Okay, all right. And then... because I know that in terms of your practice, you started off as a dentist. But I don't know how you...
I specialized in maxillofacial and oral surgery. And we treat muscular pain of the face. And that led me on to migraine because migraine is basically a muscle tension problem.
Okay. when people are hearing that you are the king of solving headache problems, they're probably wanting to come to your practice. How are the costs structured if I would want to visit your practice?
And, okay. Well, the first thing we have to do is we've got to do a very in-depth diagnosis to make sure exactly what the problem is, where the problem is coming from. And for that, we charge 6,500 rand.
Okay.
That doesn't include treatment because before we can ascertain exactly what the problem is, we can't say what the treatment will cost. So then we have to, once we found out, but the big thing is that once we've treated people, whichever treatment we choose, they don't have to take medication again, which means they don't have to spend a lot of money on medication all the time.
Yes.
And they don't have the side effects of the medication.
Yeah.
So the results are terrific. And you know, if people want to see what sort of results we're getting, they should go to, they should go on Google, they should look up the headache clinic Google reviews.
Yes.
And see the comments from the patients.
True.
They're fantastic.
True.
I sometimes read them myself.
Yeah, because I'm one of the testaments that this thing does work.
Yeah.
You didn't give me any medication.
No,
you gave
I don't know what we call it,
a PMA. What do we call that?
Yeah, that's short for posture modifying appliance. It's it's a plate. It's worn in the palate, as you know. It's very comfortable. You don't even know it's there. And it relaxes all the muscles.
Yeah, and it works so effectively because after visiting your practice, I put on that plate for 2 weeks consistently. But because now you've told me what my problem is, that I'm biting my teeth at the back, therefore my tongue is not relaxed. It's not its position. I knew after 2 weeks I took it off. I'm like, okay, let me see how I'm positioning my tongue all the time. It just became a thing of the past. I would just get a normal headache here and there, but I don't struggle from those things anymore.
Well, that's fantastic. There are not many people that can do that.
Mm.
Most people, when they wear a PMA, they've got to wear it for longer. But to wear it for 2 weeks and have that kind of result, that's fantastic.
No, because I had even really lost mine. I found it recently. Yeah, that's just how how effective the method works.
Mm.
And then do you accept, in terms of payments, are there payment arrangements?
We try and make it easy for people. We know that people are in pain.
Mm.
So we make easy payment arrangements, really.
And then are you only available, I know your practice, the one I visited, is in Parktown in Johannesburg?
Yeah, in Empire Road.
And then do you have other places where you're consulting, where people can see?
No, I used to go to Durban and Cape Town, but it was too much for me. So now the people from Durban and Cape Town come to Johannesburg.
Not even people from Cape Town, people from all over the world.
We get them from all over the world. Yes. With COVID, it was difficult, but we got our first American patient 2 weeks ago.
Okay.
And he's leaving today to go back.
So how long do these patients that are coming from other countries?
From overseas, we ask them to come for a month.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, just in case, because sometimes they need a few treatments.
Yes.
So they've got to come for a month, and we're getting great results.
No, I have to say, I listened to the recorded reviews as well. I read the ones on Google Review as well. And I must say that you are doing a very great job, you and your entire team. So thank you so much. Thank you so much. You're transforming lives.
It really, you can't imagine what pleasure my work gives me. You know what they say, if you love your work, you never have to work again.
You are not working. You are living a dream.
I'm just having fun.
So thank you for coming, Dr. Shabala. I really appreciate
you
taking time off your busy schedule.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. I hope you guys at home enjoyed the show. And if you want to consult Dr. Shabala, we'll show you the contact details on the screen and you can always contact the Headache Clinic. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.